Well, the CEO and medical aid, the CEO of medical aid scheme, rather, Profmed, Craig Comrie, says he's concerned about how South Africa's COVID-19 acquisition is going to be funded. He joins us now on the line. Craig, a very good evening to you, and thanks for your time. Firstly, let's just maybe begin with discussing what you as Profmed understand to be the plan when it comes to this cross-subsidization that we've been told about.
Thank you, Kathy, and good evening to you and your viewers. We've been following this and been engaged with the Department of Health for quite some time in terms of the request from the minister that's asked schemes to actually pitch in to fund the vaccines, not only for medical scheme members, but for those that are not insured or covered by medical schemes. So the initial funding request effectively asks schemes to use members' monies to fund the vaccines for those that aren't members. That unfortunately is outside the legal ambit and powers of a medical scheme. Our mandate from members is to only use their funds, which we hold pretty much in trust, for medical expenses. And so it is quite difficult to now try and find a mechanism to answer the minister's call to assist with the funding. So we have been engaging and trying to find the right solution in terms of how we can contribute, and that we do want to contribute to the success of the vaccine.
Of course, we know that private medical schemes do benefit from some of the tax rebates that are offered. Is another option perhaps to look at for the government to remove that benefit for this year to try and cover the cost? Is that an option at all?
Yeah, I think the issue at the moment is to actually understand what the price, the overall price of the vaccine is. So it's not just the price that that the government has procured from the different manufacturers. It is, in fact, the cost of getting the vaccine into or to a person. So it comes with distribution and other administrative costs. So if that cost and the estimations are anywhere between 260 to 700 rand, if that is the cost of the vaccine, is it within the affordability of the scheme to use members' monies to actually fund additional costs? And so for many smaller medical schemes and those that have been struggling with sustainability, it does become quite a difficult funding request. And what we are saying is that the minister, with all the right intent, probably has unfair expectations that scheme must actually fund this additional cost. A tax mechanism, as you quite rightly point out, is in fact the right mechanism to cross-subsidize the health interests in the country.
Sure, but my question is specifically around a tax mechanism that affects the medical aid schemes and not necessarily that affects the entire population, because I think why the minister would have even brought this to the table is because we have incredible inequality in this country, and therefore an incredible number of people who wouldn't be able to afford that vaccine on their own.
That's very true. And so the whole issue is how to fund it. I think the question mark and the challenge from the minister is, in fact, that medical schemes have some reserves that should be used to fund this. And our point of view is a little bit different, is to say the raising of tax, whether if you do it on a single basis, is the way that you actually equitably fund the vaccines for those that cannot afford it. It's very difficult to approach schemes within the Medical Schemes Act and ask them to actually take those funds which belong to members and use it for the purpose that they weren't intended for. So we're trying to find the right mechanism, and we have suggested an alternative in terms of how we funded some of the PPE and testing last year. The Solidarity Fund was a great initiative where people out of their own could actually, on a voluntary basis, donate money to actually provide PPE support in terms of fighting COVID. We think that's a route and a mechanism already in place that could be utilized in a more positive way. It is a fairer way than targeting, I guess, what is the medical schemes industry. We have a lot of other industries that benefit in the same way from receiving vaccines. There's lots of the economy that's gone down because of lockdown and so forth. You know, everybody will benefit from herd immunity. And so everybody should pay their share. And so medical schemes already will cover the vaccines for their own members, which is estimated to be in the region of 3 to 4 billion rand at the moment.
So, just speaking about Profmed alone, how much do you have in reserves, sitting in trusts?
Yeah, so it is in trust accounts. So we have just close to 900 million rand at the moment. And so if you look across the industry, the schemes have between 60 and 70 billion rand. You don't have to look very far to find, I guess, other businesses that have lots of reserves. But remember, that money has been contributed for some of our members over 50 years to line reserve for their future healthcare costs. And so to volunteer that now for vaccines that they don't benefit for is quite difficult for us to do. We are suggesting that medical scheme members get an opportunity to actually vote and support the social solidarity call, and then they can volunteer some of their funds to be paid over to the vaccination funding requirements.
So
we think it should be a voluntary process.
So effectively, while you as the scheme may not fully support the proposal that is being put forth by the minister, you are saying that you're open to the possibility of letting your members decide whether or not they want to contribute to perhaps a vaccine for somebody else.
You're absolutely right. We're trying to find the right mechanism to do that, but the current mechanism on the table is certainly not within our abilities at the moment. So there are many of our members that want to contribute, and we've heard from them. So we think it is every medical scheme member's responsibility to actually have their voice heard in terms of what they can contribute to the better and the greater good of South Africa.
All right, let's leave it there. Craig Comrie is the CEO of Medical Aid Scheme, Profmed.